Before we perform our final piece, I just want to say a few thanks and talk and catch my breath. First of all, thank you to Mike Alimo for the invitation to for this opportunity for me to work with the Cardinal Band. Since he asked about a year ago, I've been looking forward to this day, this chance to work with this group and be here at this Honor Band Festival. And thanks to also all of the Iowa State faculty and staff for running such a wonderful festival for students. Even though I'm an alum of another nearby university, it's been great to bring students here for the last 15 years. I've been bringing students here because they always have a wonderful experience. It's centered around music. As Mike had mentioned earlier, not just the honor bands and what we do here, but they get a chance to hear the very fine wind ensemble, and also the guest artists who come in, some clinics, and work with the faculty here. It's just a great, great festival. So thank you, Mike, and all of the Iowa State people. I thanked them earlier, but I want to also thank the directors for bringing the students here, and also not only having them here, but having them so well prepared. It was so nice to come in and have these students. You know, we didn't work on notes, we didn't work on rhythms, we didn't work on tone qualities, things like that. All of those things were well in hand, and that says a lot about their learning, the teaching going on in their band programs. And so thank you to those directors who have the students and have them so well prepared for this type of an event like this. Also thanks to the parents, because these students aren't just good musicians. They are really good people, and they've been great to work with in these last 2 days. We've asked a lot of them. If you've seen that schedule, I think, I don't know, somewhere around 7 hours of rehearsal or something yesterday, in addition to some concerts and the clinics and all of that. And then get up less than 12 hours later and do it again this morning and rehearse for 3 more hours, and then come back for another 45 minutes in the afternoon and rehearse and give a concert. So, and they were great the entire time, just working hard, and it's nice. I tell them to do things, and they do it. And it's that says a lot about the parenting, I think, too. So thank you to the parents. And most of all, thanks to these students again for the hard work in the last day and a half, making my time here so enjoyable. It was great to work with them, and as I said, they're neat people too. So, what I would like to tell them, and tell the parents here, we gave them a few stories. I also direct the Iowa City Community Band, and my first chair clarinet player is Jaime Boxman, which is a name that most people may not know, but anywhere in the band world, they know Jaime Boxman. He wrote the Rubank Advanced Method books that have been the standard textbook for bands since the 50s, and he's been the director of the School of Music at the University of Iowa, and he's now 95 years old, and is still my first chair clarinet player in the community band. Not because he's 95 years old and he's Jaime Boxman, but because he really plays the clarinet at age 95. And I'm really fortunate that one of my clarinet students still takes lessons with him every week. So Jaime is still playing, still teaching, as a testament to the fact that this is a lifelong experience, a lifelong knowledge and skill these students can take with them when they leave high school. Told them, go on into college. Doesn't matter if you're majoring in music, almost especially if you're not majoring in music. You might need to be in band just for an avocation, and you're going to find a lot of these people like you see on stage here, like you, in college, playing in bands. And after college, playing community bands, and continue to play your instrument. Don't stick it under the bed or in the closet and forget about it. So, thanks again to Mike for the opportunity to be here. Thank you for coming to support these students in the concert. We're going to finish with a march written by another Iowa icon in the band world, Frank Pearsall, who was director of bands here at Iowa State University, also director of bands at University of Iowa. And Frank is a little bit younger than Jaime, he's 94, and still comes to my concerts in Iowa City, and great to have people like that around, icons in the band world, and he's a great composer, and we're going to finish with Circus Days, Frank Circus. Frank Pearsall March. Thank you.